جايين من كل مكان للصويرة زينة البلدان زورون رجع فرحان كفى بيلو للهيلولا حط سلحوتو محيلة ضربو شنفرة الليلة
بشوت مغيب ربوتاي ودي بيبي شلوف هشام دي باراشا اوف ديس ويك بعلوتخا I can write a book about this parasha. There is so many things, this parasha, so many things that we learn how to serve Hashem, how to have more emunah on HaKadosh Baruch Hu. I would like to take just something in the parasha. Hashem is saying to Moshe Rabbeinu, Moshe, tell Aaron, as you know, that the Bnei Israel They had a portion of land in Eretz Israel, but the Shevet Levi had no portion of land. Shevet Levi, they were all the time at the service of the Bnei Israel. All the time they were there at the service. They work at the Beit HaMikdash. They sing. Well, they teach Torah to the Bnei Israel. So the Shevet Levi were a special Shevet, a special tribe, that it was only for the Bnei Israel. So, of course, they need Parnassa. From where are they going to live? So, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he said to Bnei Israel, you take charge of them. You have to give them money, you have to give them food, you have to be like Issachar and Zvulun. So, I think from here, the Rambam understand that anyone who study Torah, he become like Shevet Levi. Why? Because somebody who study Torah, he has no parnasa. All day he is in the college. All day he study Torah. From where he going to live? From where? Who's going to give him to? And the Ha'olam Omed Ala Torah. The word stands for the Torah. So if nobody study Torah, it's a problem. You know, one day the Gaon Mivilna, he was, I think, 10 or 11 year old. After Kippur, you know what he did? He went to the Beit HaMidrash. So his father, the morning when he woke up, he sees that Eliyahu, the Bey, he saw he's not in the house. So he thought maybe he woke up, he went to the Beit HaMidrash. When he went to the Beit HaMidrash, he saw his son, that all the table was full of books. He said, what time did you wake up? He said, well, Papa, I didn't sleep yet. I didn't sleep. So I asked him, you didn't eat? He said, no, I didn't eat yet. So how? He said, Papa, the Gemara said, Ha'olam Omed Al Torah. The Gemara said that the word, it stands for the Torah. And after Kippur, everybody go to eat. If everybody go to eat, so who will, with which zechut, the word will be standing? So I didn't sleep. I studied Torah to understand that way. Bemet, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he give us Issachar and Zvulun. I was always asking, why Issachar and Zvulun? Issachar studied Torah, Zvulun work for him to give him what he need. Why? Because as I said, Ha'olam Omed Al Torah Ve'Al Avodah. We need people. The world need people that with the zechut of the Torah, the zechut of the prayer, with the tefillah, the word we stand. But we need the hesed, the agmul hasadim. So we have Zvulun. So Zvulun Issachar. Zvulun Issachar is the one that he give Torah be'avodah, and Zvulun is the one who does hesed. Hesed. But as you know, that when Zvulun, Baruch Hashem, is billionaire, he's rich, he has a good panasa, and he can support everyone, he must study Torah as well. He is Zvulon for his Issachar only when he has to work. But when he has Baruch Hashem work, he becomes like Issachar, and he should stay and learn Torah. Now we understand why HaKadosh Baruch Hu give us Shevet Levi. Yoru Mishpatecha li Yaakov, Torahcha li Israel. Why Hashem give us Shevet Levi? So that Shevet Levi can teach Torah to Am Israel and he can work in the Beit HaMikdash. As I told you now, that because Shevet Levi, they had no parnasa, because they have to take care of the Bnei Israel, so HaKadosh Baruch Hu he told Israel, you take care of them. So now from here we understand what the Rambam said. The Rambam said, not only Shevet Levi, that they are the names Shevet Levi because and they belong to Hashem because they are connected to the Mikdash to the Ben Israel, any Jew from any Shevet, Yehuda, Issachar, Zvulon, Binyamin, Dan, Naphtali, any kind of Jew who want to become like Shevet Levi. How? They want to study Torah. So he become like a Levi. Where you li alvim. Li, it's gematria 40. Li. 40, lamed yud. What it is li? They are my Leviim. That means anyone who studied the Torah that was given after 40 days, he become my Levi. I think from here, the Rambam talk is big chidush that any Jew who studied Torah, he become like Shevet Levi. But there is something very interesting in this parasha. Mamash. Something incredible. Then I will tell you a personal story that happened to me yesterday morning in Chicago. Mamash Ashgacha Pratit. First, my friend, Hashem is to Moshe Rabbeinu. He told him, V'kravta et ha-Levi ifne Hashem v'sevecho v'nei said that you approach the Leviim. There were a few thousand. And all the Jews will put their hand on their head. And then Aharon will take each Levi v'inif. That means like a wave, you know, il les balance. You know, he moved them. Just imagine how many thousands of Leviim. And Aharon was a very old man. He was maybe 84, 80. Can you imagine every time he hold one Levi, you know, and he move him, you know, like waves, you know, he move, he balance. I did not understand why this. I did not understand. Even Korah, he make a joke of that. Korah, when he was against Moshe, he said to the Jews, "This Moshe Rabbeinu, look what he did to us. He took us like animals, you know, and he moved us, you know, like Sha'ana, you know, like you take a lulav." I did not understand why Aaron he had to do that. And then, with that, you know what the Leviim did? The Leviim ismicho itidim arosh aparim. And then the Leviim, they put their hand on the head of the cows. I did not understand. And then, Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, take all the Leviim, put them again next to Aaron. V'hinifotam, v'imidei talifne Aaron, v'ifne bale, v'hinafta otam t'nufa l'Hashem. Again, tan. I did not understand. And then once he did that, so with Delta. Now they are separate the Leviim from the Bnei Israel. Now the Leviim become mine. And then they can take care of it. I did not understand why. I thought this. When you want to buy something, you have to do a kinyan. Understand? When you want to buy something, you know, when a man wants to get married, what you do? A kinyan. He buy. This is mine. You know, he took the ketubah with a kippah, and he said, this is mine. This is kinyan. I buy it. So now Hashem said, the Leviim become, automatically, they become like a rechush. They become something to, like when the man, he buy his wife, he is in charge of his wife. It's his. He must take care of her. So now Hashem, he said, because now the Leviim, they have become yours, so you have to do a kinyan. So like Aharon is doing a kinyan for the Bnei Israel, then they are Yuli Alvim, then the Leviim will be mine. But this, there is a big imuna, you know. When somebody studies Torah, he must have a big imuna that the Torah Magino Matsuli. You have to be convinced. Otherwise, it's not worth it to read it, just to do it. When you study Torah, Li, the Torah that was given after 40 years, you must have Emunah that you are doing the Ratzon Hashem. You do the will of Hashem. That Be'emet, Hashem is enjoying what you are doing. You must have, I promise you, yesterday in the plane, I was very tired after a bad, after 3 days with no sleep, here in Chicago, I was very, I thought at least I will sleep 1 hour and a half in the plane instead of afternoon. But I had a question in my mind, a question. So when I started to sleep, suddenly I started to have an answer for the question. So quick, I woke up, I took the pen, I write for 1 hour and a half. Why? And I enjoyed what I was doing. Why? Because I didn't want to forget. I said, David, how should we give you now an opportunity to understand something that you had a question about? So don't forget it, write it. And I enjoyed this. I mean, Torah, it's a ta'anug, it's a pleasure. This is the Torah. So, Rabotai, you don't buy something you don't like. You understand me? You don't buy something you don't like. You don't do a kinyan for a wife to get married. If you don't like her, you will not marry her. You will not do a ketubah. You will not be under the chuppah. So the Torah is the same. It's a kinyan. It's you buy the Torah. It's a kinyan. The Torah should be a part of you, like the woman that she's a part of the husband, that it has to take care of her. So we have to take care of our wife, of the Torah, and to do read. That's why Hashem, he said to Aaron, now Aaron, I want you to be the shaliach, to do the kinyan for the Bnei Israel, for the Levim, so the Levim, they are mine, and now they have to take. But you need emunah. I mean, all the Jewish people, they were looking what Aaron was doing. At that moment, I think, can you imagine a few thousand people, Aaron, an old man, to hold each levy and to move him? I mean, it's crazy. I mean, every Jew, when he saw what Aaron was doing, he was feeling, he was focusing, feeling, the Torah is my Kenyan. The Torah is my Kenyan. Always the Sarah, when it comes to Torah, he is driving you crazy. He puts you bad thoughts in your mind. You want to study Torah? What for? It's not worth it. Go to work. Go enjoy yourself. Go, see a television. You know, text to your friends. Allez, eh. But Rabotai, at that moment, Moshe Rabbeinu, when he did what he did, and he taught Aaron to do the tnufa, to move each levy, and to be a part of the kinyan for Am Israel. You know, if every Jew, he was not thinking, laughing, look what he's doing, this old man. No, he was thinking about himself. He's doing my kinyan. This is the kinyan. And that's why the Levim, they put their hand on the Rashi Parim. Parim, if it's from the word Rafim. What it is Rafim? Rafui de Torah. That means Rafim, somebody that says, what is Rafim? Rafui Adab Midivre Torah. Hein? They are weak. The Satan, or his koah, is to make you weak to study Torah. So the Levim, there, when they put their hand on each on the cows, we call it parim. But parim is the same word of rafim. That means that the title, the purpose, not the purpose, the mission of the Levim, it's to be Mechazek, the Bnei Israel, not to be Rafim Yidehem in Devar Torah. That was Hashem gave. Hashem gave us Levim, not just to work in the Beit HaMikdash for himself. No, for Am Israel, to wake them up. When they see any Jew that is weak in the Limud Torah, the title is, the mission is to give him Chizuk, to give him strength, to carry on, to learn Torah. This is Rabotai, this beautiful parasha. That Akash Baruch Hu, he did a kinyan for the Bnei Israel. The Levim now become a kinyan. What kind of kinyan? That they will teach them Torah, and they will have no business, they have no real estate, they have no shops, no supermarket, nothing. Either here just to strengthen them on the Limud Torah. And that it was the tachlis that Aaron was doing this tenufa for the Levim, to buy them, to be the Kenyan for the Am Yisrael, to be the Kenyan for HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to be the Kenyan, because the Torah, it needs a Kenyan. The Torah, don't think the Torah, you can get it like that. Like if you want to buy a suit, you have to give money. So the Leviim is the Kenyan. If you want to be Kone the Torah, you need a Kenyan. You need to buy the Torah. So Baruch Hashem, the Leviim were here to be our Kenyan. They are here to protect us, to push us, to learn Torah, and not to make, and that moment, it was a moment very, very special, that nobody joked, nobody laughed, everybody took this very serious, very serious, that the Leviim are the Kenyan of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and each Jew, he become a Kenyan to HaKadosh Baruch Hu while he studied Torah, like the Leviim. But I went to Chicago for 2 days, but I thought I was supposed to arrive here this morning from Chicago. I was supposed to fly from Chicago this morning and to stay there 2 days. And then I decided, no, I have to be here this morning, I have to stay the night here, because I had a few things to do last night, so I decided to change with Hananiah the tickets. And then the ticket that's to arrive here about 9 o'clock in the evening. No, to arrive here at one o'clock in the night. After I said it's too much, 1 o'clock. We change the ticket again. To arrive here at 8 o'clock. And then I change the ticket again. And you know, every time you change the ticket, you lose money. And then my wife, she told me, David, what are you doing? You lost a lot of money. It's the ticket instead of will be X, it's going to be double, because every time you have to pay a penalty for the ticket. I said, I know, but I have to leave at 2 o'clock. I have to be there at 5 o'clock in New York. But why? I don't know. Be'ezat Hashem, before I leave Chicago, I have emunah. That Hashem, because all the people that I was supposed to receive till for 2 days, I did that I will receive them on Tuesday and half day is today. Voilà. Right. And then I said, Hashem, but now I'm losing a few thousand dollars for the tickets. Hashem, I want you to prove me that I will not lose them. Prove me that Hashem. You know what I did? I did that for you. Because I have things to do, it's for you. So Hashem, before I leave the house where I receive people, I want somebody to come, somebody that I don't know, and he will pay me all the tickets. So I will be happy. Hashem is a witness. My wife, she called me again. I think you're doing a mistake. Again, you lose money. Say, Vivian, you will see HaKadosh Baruch Hu will pay me back all the 3 times that I changed the tickets. I said, you don't. About yesterday, I received people till the time, 11 o'clock, the time that I had to leave to go to the airport. There is somebody who came. And he came for a bracha. And that never happened. He told you, what can I do for you? What can I pay for you? What can I do for you? I was thinking about the tickets. Bemet, I was thinking about the tickets. It's somebody I don't know. Usually people, they leave a donation, they go, but what can I do for you? Personally, for you. I said, for me, whatever you want. And then he bought a check of $7,200. So I said to myself, Hashem, he paid me back the tickets. He paid all the penalties that I did, plus a profit. This is the emunah. When you believe in Hashem, it's a man that I don't know. I don't know. He was the last one. The last, and he was not supposing to come. He was driving, and he He heard that a rabbi, so he decided to come. This is Emunah. So can you imagine with the Bnei Israel, they saw Aharon doing this Hanafa, moving the Levim. They should have Emunah that what he's doing is their Kinyan. It's a Kinyan that the Levim belong to them and they have to take care of them, they have to pay them, they have to give them money, like we do for those who study Torah. So it's a Kinyan for all the Bnei Torah. A Ben Torah, you have to think that if you don't study Torah, you cannot live. You would people would think that we are doing a favor to the Bnei Torah. You don't know that it's the Bnei Torah who are doing a favor, that they are sitting studying Torah. Because they want to enjoy themselves as well. They want to go out. They want to see the world. And what do? They sit and study Torah. While you go, you do whatever you want to do. So so this is something that we have to learn. Thank you. Shekosh Baruch Hu give you bracha v'atzlacha. Take sometimes out of your time and come be'ezrat Hashem. Do your best to come to study Torah in the morning, the evening with the kollel that you have here. And Shekosh Baruch Hu ten lachem bracha v'atzlacha.